Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Learn Nursing Easy with me. If you are the first time watching my video, please like, share, subscribe and click the notification button and stay tuned. Today we will see a nursing care plan on a patient with peptic ulcer disease. So, peptic ulcer disease is a condition where there is erosion and ulceration of the gastric mucosa, which is caused by a bacteria called as Helicobacter pylori infection, or it can be due to starving, where there is increased HCl production and there is no food to neutralize the acids, which can result in gastric irritation and injury to the gastric mucosa. First diagnosis is acute pain related to gastric irritation, secondary to erosion of the gastric mucosa from increased gastric acid secretion. So here peptic ulcers, they cause irritation and erosion of the gastric mucosa, where the nerves are also getting eroded, which can result in pain. So objective is client will report relief from pain. So here you have to assess all the precipitating factors: quality, radiation, severity and frequency of the pain. So mainly patients, after taking food, they may complain of pain, and quality, it will be like a burning pain, and radiation, it can radiate to the shoulders or the back. And severity, so most patients with severe ulceration will have a severe pain. So all those factors you have to collect, so this will help in planning interventions. And you have to provide comfortable right lateral position with pillow supported, so that will provide comfort. And advise the patient not to take hot and spicy foods, because they can cause further irritation, and patient should take only soft solids and bland diet. So like kanji, curd, so like those bland diet can be given. And you have to give diversional therapy and relaxation techniques in the form of watching TV and distracting the mind of the patient, so that patient will not feel the pain. And you have to tell the patient to take more of oral fluids with meals, so this will help in neutralizing the gastric acids and thereby it will prevent irritation. And drugs like H2 receptor antagonist, like ranitidine, cimetidine, proton pump inhibitors like pantoprazole, syrups like ranitidine O, and antimicrobial agents like metrogyl. So these are all prescribed in order to neutralize the gastric acid and also prevent the pain and the pylori infection. And we have to give psychological support, so this will help in gaining confidence and provide comfort. And cytoprotective drugs like syrup sulfapralfate is available. This will help in healing of the ulcerated wound, and also it can relieve. In case patient is having a severe peptic ulcer disease, then we have to put a NG tube and suction the gastric contents and keep the patients on nilperoral, which is nothing by mouth, and this will help to rest the stomach and also treat the edema and inflammation in the stomach. Thereby patient's pain will be relieved. And next diagnosis is imbalance nutrition, less than body requirements related to indigestion, gastric irritation after eating, secondary erosion and ulceration of the GI mucosa. So mostly these patients will have pain after eating, so patient will abstain from eating, and these patients will have history of starving, etc. So I made this diagnosis. The goal is to maintain ideal body weight and take sufficient nutrients. In interventions, you have to assess the nutritional status and nutritional needs of the client. So this will help to provide intervention based on the patient's nutritional needs. And you have to check weight daily, so this will help in assessing any nutritional deficit. And you have to tell the patient to take soft, solid and bland diet and avoid hot and spicy food, so this will prevent gastric irritation. Tell the patient to avoid smoking, alcoholism, caffeine and carbonated drinks, so this will prevent further gastric erosion. And these patients, they have to take at least 6 meals, and that is small and frequent feeds per day, so this will help in neutralizing the acids in the stomach. And whenever patient is taking the food, tell him to chew nicely and then swallow. So if the patient swallow like that, they can have problem with digestion, so they have to chew the food and eat. And H2 receptor antagonist, proton pump inhibitor, so this all will neutralize the gastric acid and thereby they promote healing of the gastric ulcers. And cold, clear liquids and odorless, colorless fluid should be given, so this will prevent gastric irritation and also prevent nausea, vomiting. And IV fluids like colloids and crystalloids should be given if oral fluids are not tolerated, so this will improve the fluid status and also nutritional status of the client. And if the patient is kept on nilparoral, you can replace it with total parenteral nutrition. So in case patient is having severe peptic ulcer disease, so this helps in to rest the stomach and also treat the edema and inflammation of the stomach. Insert nasogastric tube and aspirate the gastric contents or do intermittent suctioning for the first 24 to 48 hours. This helps in the stomach to rest and also remove any causative factors. And all this will improve the nutritional status of the client. Next diagnosis is deficient fluid volume related to vomiting and inability of the stomach to ingest, digest and absorb foods and fluids. Secondly, to erosion of gastric mucosa. Our goal is to maintain a normal fluid volume status. So here intake output chart will be monitored, weight will be monitored. So this all will show how much fluid volume status is there. And IV fluids, colloids and albumin has to be administer, so this will improve the fluid volume status. Antiemetic drugs will be given to treat vomiting, and sips of water as and when needed you have to provide. This will prevent dryness and oral hygiene, and you have to tell the patient to floss the mouth regularly, so this will remove bad odors and also prevent dryness. And in case there is any deficient of electrolyte, this has to be replaced in the form of fluids or electrolyte has to be replacement has to be done. And administer total parenteral nutrition in case of nilparoral status, so this will increase the fluid volume. And once oral intake is tolerated, advise the patient to take more of liquid diet. And H2 receptor antagonists like ranitidine and protopop inhibitors like pantoprazole, this all will be given in order to treat the ulcers so that patient can normally ingest and digest the food. So here the evaluation fluid volume status will be improved. Okay, and then these patients, due to gastric irritation, they may go for internal bleeding, and this can result in hemorrhage. Okay, so this for hemorrhage related to erosion of gastric mucosa causing damage to the blood vessels. So our goal is to prevent bleeding. Here you have Michael signs and level of consciousness should be monitored. So if there is any decrease in blood pressure and loss of consciousness, then it will reveal that patient is having an internal bleeding which can cause shock and collapse. So you have to assess all the body orifices for any bleeding, like in case of hematemesis, melena. So hematemesis, sorry, blood in the vomiting, and melena is blood in the stools. So you have to monitor that, and intake output chart again you have to monitor, because if there is decreased urine output, then we know the patient is going for a circulatory collapse. And nilparoral status should be kept for the first 24 to 48 hours. So this can help in monitoring if there is any GI bleeding. And NG tube will be inserted, and you have to aspirate gastric contents to identify if there is any internal bleeding in the stomach. IV fluid should be administered, so this will increase the circulatory volume and prevent shock. Keep all emergency articles near the bedside of the patient, because if there is an internal bleeding, suddenly patient can go for collapse. So you have to do emergency management, and mainly sense taken Blackmore tube has to be kept. So if there is an internal bleeding when we do a NG section and there is more bleeding, then we have to arrest the bleeding. So this tube will be used, and reassurance should be given for patient and family if there is any active bleeding. So this will relieve anxiety. And antacids like aluminium hydroxide and magnesium salt, so this will help in treating of ulcerations. And prepare the client for endoscopic or surgical intervention as prescribed by the doctor. So with all this, bleeding can be prevented. The person may go for a bleeding or a perforation. Perforation is where the gastric mucosa can get ruptured and the gastric contents can go into the peritoneal cavity or other organs. So risk for gastrointestinal perforation related to impure mucosal tissue integrity, secondary to ulceration and erosion of the GI mucosa. So our goal is to prevent the gastrointestinal perforation. Intervention, abdominal assessment, mainly the gastrointestinal assessment is performed. So this will reveal pain, abdominal distension, tightening of the abdomen and decreased bowel sounds. And vital signs should be monitored every 15 to 30 minutes to identify if patient is going for shock. And nasogastric tube should be inserted, and stomach contents has to be aspirator, so the stomach will be decompressed and there won't be leakage of fluids if there is a perforation. And NPO status and total parenteral nutrition should be given, so this is to meet the nutritional status. And analgesics like diclofenac or tramadol can be given to relieve pain. Emergency articles again should be kept at the bedside to meet emergencies, and H2 receptor antagonists, proton pump inhibitors Ranitidone was syrup. So these all will decrease the acid secretion, and also they have anesthetic effect on the stomach, and there will be desensitization of the pain. And if the patient is going for perforation, you have to get ready for the surgical procedure. So you have to prepare the client. So with all this, patient will be prevented from GI perforation. And next is anxiety. If patient is having a severe peptic ulcer disease and he is going for surgical intervention, then patient may go for anxiety. So anxiety related to the acute GI illness and the need for invasive or surgical intervention. So our goal is to relieve anxiety. So here you have to assess the level of anxiety and vital signs. So with this we can identify what intervention we can provide, and surgical procedure should be explained in understandable terms and reassure the client about the prognosis, so patient may gain confidence and orient the client to the operating room and procedure, so that patient will have knowledge of what procedure is going to take place in his body, and obtain consent before doing any procedures. So you have to explain everything and you have to get consent, so this will gain confidence, and also it serves as a legal document and provide psychological support and positive reinforcement. So this will relieve anxiety and introduce the client to other person who have undergone the same surgery and is progressing well. So this will gain confidence and relieve anxiety, and spiritual support like telling the patient to do prayer and be done. So this will promote hope, and if permitted, allow family members to stay with the client and not to leave the patient alone. So again, family members can provide better support for the patient. Anxiolytic psychrestil, so this will relieve anxiety, and sedatives like diazepam. So if patient is having insomnia and fear, because of fear patient may not sleep, so you can give diazepam, and all the doubts of the client should be cleared. So this will help in gaining confidence and relieving anxiety. So with this, anxiety of the client will be relieved. And finally, deficient knowledge regarding the therapeutic regimen, prognosis and home care activities. So our goal is to provide adequate knowledge, and here you have to assess the clients and significance, other ability to understand instructions, and we have to also include family members while teaching. And dietary management, like in case patient is going home with NG feeding, you have to demonstrate the procedure, how to feed the tube. So this demonstration I have already taught, the link will be shared in the description, please look into it. And educate the client about nutritional therapy, like avoiding spicy, heavy, solid foods and to take liquid diet. And client disease condition, complications, etc. should be explained, and also advise the client to come to the hospital if complications occur. And regarding drug therapy and the side effects you have to treat, and also how to manage the side effects, you have to teach them. And advise the client to come for follow-up visits. So in case patient is having a surgical intervention home with sutures, then you have to tell them when they have to come back for removal of sutures and also further laboratory checkup. And advise strictly to avoid alcohol, smoking, caffeine and all the carbonated drinks. And advise client to monitor for signs of bleeding and notify the hospital if any active bleeding occurs. So this all will help in preventing complications. So teach the client how to care the surgical site and wash hands before carrying the surgical site, and also how to dress the surgical area. So this will prevent infection, and patient has to avoid all the strenuous exercises and lifting heavy objects at least for 6 months to 1 year. The patient should not do heavy activities, that you have to tell. This can prevent further strain to the surgical area. And avoid stress and perform relaxation technique like meditation, yoga, prayer. So this all will provide psychological support and relieve stress. Finally, advise the family members to support the client and to make lifestyle changes if needed, and cope with the patient's disease condition. If family is supporting the client will feel better, and also they can follow the therapeutic regimen. So with all this, client gains knowledge. So I hope you have understood my class. Thank you for listening. Please like, share, subscribe and click the notification button and stay tuned.